how much does that help you with the preparations this week, knowing who's here, who's not?
Yeah, I think it's good, right? Get a couple of good practices in, try to set the foundation here, and then. But as we know in this league, things change quickly. So, but yeah, it looks good right now.
How do you amp up the guys for that opening night over the next couple days?
I don't know if we need to do that. I think they, yeah, I think they're excited the season's starting, and I think that's, you know, the first five games. There's always a lot of energy, a lot of young guys, and they want to prove themselves. And so I don't need more. So maybe rein them back a little bit.
What about you as a coach? I mean, this year, I mean, there's obviously more hype just kind of surrounding the organization as a whole. Does that give you a little more extra juice coming in and out of the building every day as you get ready for the season?
I honestly think it's day by day for us. You know, we're just focused on the process, the things that we can control. You know, I think it's an exciting group to be part of, an opportunity to work with these young guys, and that's kind of how we look at it, more excitement than anything.
Nolan Allen won't be coming back down here. He got the roster spot up there after, I think it was like 60 games up here last season. What did you see from him that, you know, got him a shot at the NHL level this year?
Well, he had a really good camp. He was, you know, played to his strengths, you know, played within himself, and he kind of knows what he is, and I think that's a huge benefit when you're at that age. And it's one of the first things for young guys to kind of figure out, who am I as a player and what am I going to be? And I think he's done that, and he showed that in camp.
Kevin Korchinski starts the season here after playing 76 games, I think, up with Chicago last year. How much of sending him and some of the other young guys down here is just to get them part of a winning environment? Not to say the Blackhawks can't win this year, but they're a couple years away probably. But how important is it for these young guys to experience that winning environment?
Yeah, good question. I think for Kevin, everybody's different, right? Everybody's paths are different. I think for him, you know, more so land, play a lot, development time, extra practice time. Practice time is rare to come by in NHL, so for young guys like that, an extra, you know, couple of practices a week, an extra couple of lifts in the weight room is huge. And I think it's just, you know, for him to kind of find his game again. And you know, he has a lot of abilities that will translate well to NHL. It's just a matter of kind of honing on those skills down here.
Share some of those abilities with us. What is his game when he's playing at his best level?
Well, he's really, obviously the skating is elite. When he gets the puck up the ice, either by moving it or transporting it, he's at his best. Defensively, when he's, you know, in the good spots defensively, positionally, and his habits with his sticks is really good to break up plays, and then he can get going the other way.
Feels like with defensemen, their kind of path to staying at the NHL level can kind of be up and down a little bit. Like their development can, you know, go a lot of the different directions. What is it about developing a defenseman for the NHL level that maybe makes it, you know, take longer for, you know, some cases?
Great question. Again, I think everybody is different there, but I do think it takes a little bit longer for defensemen and even longer for goalies, right? So, There's just little things in the defenseman's game. The handling forwards are faster, better, quicker, right? So I think there's a lot of different. I don't know if we have time to go through it all, but I think it is a longer path a lot of times for defensemen to get there and to stay there as well. So I think that's a component that we need to kind of make sure we're mindful of when we're looking at players.
And how much of that is like just raw ability within like a player? Is it, you know, just understanding a scheme and, you know, understanding their assignments at the pro level?
Yeah, I think that's a big part of it. That's a big part of it. Just, again, finding who you are as a player. What are you going to be at that level? And even guys coming from junior now, coming to the American Hockey League. American Hockey League is an excellent league in a lot of ways. So finding out what are you going to be at the pro level, right? That's the first step. And then the next step is, what am I going to be at the NHL level, which is another level up. So,
talking about some of these young guys who are in their first pro training camp, like Mazur or Slager, what has impressed you most about those kind of guys making their first steps here in the pro level?
Willingness to just come in every day and be ready to work at their craft, but also they're inquisitive, both of them. They ask questions. They want to know, you know, what we're looking for and you know, what they can do to, you know, become better players, which I think is a good quality in a player.
And who are some of the kind of veteran presences that maybe have taken these guys under their wing or shown them a little more these first couple of weeks during camp and into week one?
Yeah, you know, it's hard for me to say. I'm not in the room every day, but, you know, you have your Sinis and your Samfords and your Baddocks of the world. You know, those guys, I'm sure, are helping the young guys out. That's something organically that happens as well. So, but those are the guys that we lean on as a staff, and definitely will here in the next couple of weeks.
You're not hurting for experience in the goaltender spot with Camesso and Ripley both back here.
Yeah.
And it all starts with goaltending. So how excited are you about that with what you have returning at that position?
Yeah, no, it's a positive for sure. Right? They've been through it for a little bit now, and they know what to expect in the league here, coming in every day, but also when you go on the road playing these teams. So I think that's a big benefit for us as a group.
We got Coach McNevin here in his first year replacing Nightingale, who worked with a defenseman, right? What have you seen from him, one of your newer coaches on the staff, you know, dealing with, like we were talking about, defensemen, that important development? What have you seen from him in his first year coaching with the staff?
All positive. He's a hockey nerd? No. But he's really detailed, loves to watch games, loves to watch clips. I think his development or his eye and his thought process for development is really good. So that's something, obviously, with the young defensemen we have, we look for. So far, it's been really good.
Does he change up the defensive philosophy at all, or he's just more working on the individual mechanics with different guys?
Yeah, no, I think it's more so. I mean, it's the same. Like, we have a structure that we set in place, and it was the same when Knighty was here or somebody else before. But, that you know, we set the structure, and then when you're in the coach that works more on individual with the players on development. I mean, we're really an extension of the development staff, or vice versa, they're an extension of us. So I think that's the biggest main responsibility when you're in that role, is working individually with the players.
Good.
Thanks, guys.
Appreciate it, Coach.